the fuck? He just totally went off the road. Which is a great segue into what another topic that I wanted to talk about, which was taking risks. I emailed back and forth, or actually messaged back and forth with another rider about taking risks while riding the motorcycles. He seems to think a lot like I do. It looks like we both got started on riding kind of later in life. You know, a lot of people get their start when they're teenagers, you know. And of course, you know, when you're a teenager, you feel invincible. I did crazy shit. You know, I fell off a cliff once, and I've been real lucky, though. I fell off a cliff, and all I really did was bang up my knee a little bit. I didn't even have to go to the doctor. Although, still to this day, nearly 16 years later, occasionally my knee will feel real tight, and if I bend it just the right way, I can pop it. I can't do that with the other knee, so I'm pretty sure it's because of that fall. But I fell off a cliff. We were rock climbing. I wasn't really taking any safety precautions. We weren't using ropes. Probably didn't even have adequate grip on our shoes. You know, we just went out in the woods and started climbing this cliff face, and I fell off from about, I don't know, 20, 30 feet, and messed up my knee. I would never do that these days. We used to go cave exploring. There's lots of caves in this area, and there were times I really didn't know if I was going to make it out alive. We went into this one area once. I went in with a guy who was about twice my size, a big guy, and he got stuck and I had to pull him out, and I didn't think I'd be able to pull him out. And the kicker is, if I hadn't been able to pull him out, I wouldn't have been able to get out, because we were in a place where this intersection always sucks. People fly over the hill over here. So anyway, like I was saying, this guy was in the cave, and he got stuck in this narrow little spot that we had to go through. We had already been through it once, but it was kind of different going back out. And had he not made it out, I would have been stuck behind him with no way to get out myself. And this was a very large cave. We were very far back in it. And he was stuck really tight, and he was panicking. And I think the more he panicked, the tighter he got stuck. It was really hard to calm him down, and at the same time I'm thinking about what's going to happen if he can't get out, or if I can't get him out, and then I got stuck behind him. So anyway, I used to do really crazy stuff, and now that I'm older, I still take risks, and sometimes I know I shouldn't. And anyway, this other guy that I was talking to online, we pretty much seem to think the same way now. I don't think either of us are afraid of our bikes. Even after I came off my bike in my wreck, you know, a while back, I was ready to ride it 2 or 3 days later. At no point was I really afraid of the bike. I was a little bit skittish going around turns, you know, because I knew that, you know, it was pretty easy to make a mistake and mess yourself up. I also acknowledge that I was very lucky for coming off the bike as fast as I did and not being seriously injured. But when I came off the bike, I wasn't... Ooh, that's a fucking nice car. Oh, I gotta come back and take a look at that. That was a 79 Special Edition Trans Am. That's awesome. Oh, lost my train of thought. My other passion is muscle cars, especially Trans Ams. That was a badass car. So anyway, so this other guy and I seem to have the same attitude about coming off the bike, and I think I've said that about 3 times now. And like I was saying, I came off the bike, and right as I hit the ground, my first thought was, wow, that didn't really hurt that bad. My second thought was, oh shit, that could have been a lot worse. I'm really lucky. But right after that, after it all kind of hit me, what had just happened, you know, and I kind of realized, what, you know, how close I came to losing it all. Yeah, there's a nice Camaro out here too. This is just muscle car heaven out here. So anyway, when I realized how close I came to being seriously injured or killed, I started thinking about my kids. And, you know, I think if I didn't have kids, I would probably ride a little faster, take a few more risks. Because I'm not really afraid, you know, to come off the bike and get hurt. I don't want to come off the bike and get hurt, but I'm not afraid of it. And even right after the crash, riding home, I was not afraid of it. But I am afraid for something to happen to me while the kids still need me for support.